Okay, students, you all can see the screen right now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Renaissance, as we were discussing yesterday, the rebirth of learning in Europe. Can you see Mona Lisa's painting?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, here. Okay. Let us go ahead. See, here on the side, you can see Mona Lisa's paintings. Can anyone guess whose these sketches can be of human body? Yesterday we discussed about him. He was a painter, he was a scientist, he was multi-genius.
Sir, Leonardo da Vinci.
Yes, very correct. Leonardo da Vinci, very correct. And Michelangelo. I talked about another very famous sculptor of that time, Michelangelo. This is one of his one of his great things. It is Mother Mary holding Jesus Christ's dead body. Can you see? Doesn't it look like real humans? It's
yes.
All made up
yes.
of metal. You can see how detailed it is. And the next, you all can see. Can you see this beautiful paintings on the roof of this building?
Yes, sir.
On the walls of this building. Sorry, roof I said. So this is the Sistine Chapel. Sistine Chapel is a very, very, very famous church in the Vatican City in Rome. And you know, Michelangelo made all these paintings. Just imagine how hard it would have been, these beautiful paintings on the walls.
Sir, it is not allowed to take pictures also of it.
I don't know exactly. I will have to go there. But there are so many pictures in the internet. If you will see, you can
yes,
also
sir.
Have a virtual tour. So definitely
but
some people get
pictures illegally.
Yeah.
It is not allowed.
It is not allowed, but they click, and definitely some may have got permission. That's why even there are videos. So I'm quickly doing a revision, which I taught you yesterday. Renaissance, literal meaning is rebirth. I am audible now to all very clearly.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So what Renaissance means, it denotes the cultural changes which took place in Europe between the 14th to 17th century. And this term, that is Renaissance, was first used by historians in 19th century. It was a period when distinct means very different, urban culture developed. You know, these cities were not new. Florence, Venice, Rome, they are old cities, but you know, these cities became centers of arts, craft, learning, science, business, commerce and trade. You know, these cities were already there, but they became new centers of such activities. Towns like Florence, then Venice. Today you all can see Venice here. I yesterday told you there are no roads, but rather there are waterways in Venice and Rome. This is the Colosseum, which I was talking about, became centers of learning and art. Next, artists and writers were patronized by the rich and aristocratic society. Yesterday in the class, I explained to you what is the meaning of the word to patronize someone. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
To pay someone to do good things.
To pay someone and to take care of someone's all needs so that they can work. You know, and they can work wonderful things. So artists and writers were patronized. This person, the first one is Martin Luther. Yesterday I told you, Martin Luther translated what to what? Can anyone tell from your previous class, yesterday's
sir,
class?
Sir, Bible.
Yes.
Latin Bible into Greek.
So Latin to Russian.
Latin Bible into that.
Okay. German, very correct.
German.
Martin Luther King, not sorry, Martin Luther, he was also a monk of the Christian church. And he raised questions against the church, against the corrupt practices of the church. And for that, you know, Martin Luther had to face various consequences. And one of the very, very, very rich businessmen, he gave shelter to Martin Luther in one of his castles. And there he, you know, kept hiding himself for a few years, where he translated the Latin Bible into German, which the common public can read. Next, he is a very famous writer. Yesterday I talked about him also. Can you guess which writer is this in the center?
Sir William Shakespeare.
Yes, very correct. William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare, we all must have heard his name, from Merchant of Venice to many, many, Julius Caesar, many great works he has done. And the next one is the self-portrait of Leonardo da Vinci. That is, Leonardo da Vinci painted himself. He sketched his own face. So that is Leonardo da Vinci. Next. Yesterday, we also talked about Johannes Gutenberg, isn't it? I told
you, yes, sir.
Of printing. It was during the printing Renaissance period that invention of printing happened, which played a very important role in the society, in changing the entire society. Because of that, books and prints could be available to the masses, to the common people. What used to happen earlier, students, that books used to be handwritten. You know, even the Bible and all these books were written by the monks in the church and other people by their hand. And only the very rich people could afford such books. But now, with the invention of this Gutenberg press, you all can see this Gutenberg press photograph. You can see people working in such a press. And this is the Gutenberg Bible. Gutenberg Bible, always remember, was one of the first books to be printed in the world. And he is Johannes Gutenberg. So, you know, suddenly everyone started getting these newspapers and the books. So books, newspapers, pamphlets, all these things started circulating in the public in large numbers. Usse kya hua? Log mein jagrukta phaili. People became aware of the truth which is written in the books. Rediscovery of glorious past. Sense of history developed in Europe. Yesterday, I explained to you all that, like in India, if we compare our ancient history, we will go to the Indus Valley civilization, to the Vedic period, we'll compare our times from Ashoka and Chandragupta Maurya. Same way, in Europe, their glorious past was the ancient Greek and Roman history. So people contrasted and compared their modern world with the ancient one of the Greeks and Romans. Next, here you can see a cross. Why I have given? Because before the beginning of Renaissance, the church dominated and controlled all aspects of life in Europe. Church jo hai wo har cheez ke upar चर्च का दबदबा था. यू नो, चर्च हर चीज को कंट्रोल करता था, लोगों को डरा के. मैंने कल आपको बताया था आफ्टर लाइफ के बारे में, डरा के यू विल गो टू हेल, सो डू दिस एंड लाइक दैट. सो चर्च वाज वेरी पावरफुल. चर्च फोकस्ड मोर ऑन लाइफ आफ्टर डेथ एंड इंडल्ज्ड इन करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस इन नेम ऑफ गॉड एंड गारंटी टू सेंड सोल्स टू हेवन. हम आपकी आत्माओं को हेवन भेजेंगे, इसके नाम पे लोग से पैसा लूटा जाता था, उनको बेवकूफ बनाया जाता था एंड व्हाट नॉट. बट रिनेसांस
हैपनिंग.
यस भूमि,
बट टुडे आल्सो इट इज हैपनिंग इन आवर सोसाइटी.
यस, इट इज हैपनिंग इवन इन इंडिया सोसाइटी आल्सो. इट इज हैपनिंग, इजंट इट भूमि? स्टिल
यस,
सच थिंग्स हैपन. राहु आपके ऊपर चढ़ा हुआ है, शनि की ये चल रही है, उसके लिए आप ये पहने, उसके लिए आप वो पहने. स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो, अगर मैं 10 उंगलियों में 10 अंगूठी अगर पहन लू एंड माई लाइफ, देन माई लाइफ शुड बी ऑल गुड, इजंट इट? यस, इजंट इट स्टूडेंट्स?
नो सर.
नहीं,
नो सर.
आई एम सेइंग अगर रियलिटी में होता तब तो मैं अपने 10 हाथों में भी पहन लेता अंगूठी, 10 पैर की उंगलियों में भी अंगूठी पहन लेता.
Yes, you know,
then my life would have heaven, all problems solved. एग्जाम देने की जरूरत नहीं है, बस अंगूठी पहनो, यू विल बिकम फर्स्ट. हाँ, वो करने की जरूरत नहीं है, ये यज्ञ करवा लो, खत्म. आई एम नॉट इंसल्टिंग, यू नो, यज्ञ एंड दीज थिंग्स ऑल्सो हैव सम साइंटिफिक थिंग्स, बट आई एम नॉट सपोर्टिंग द ब्लाइंड फेथ, अंधविश्वास को मैं नहीं सपोर्ट कर रहा हूं. सो सेम थिंग वॉज देयर विद द चर्च, बट रेनेसांस पीरियड एब्सोल्यूटली स्टार्टेड चेंजिंग एवरीथिंग. पीपल स्टार्टेड क्वेश्चनिंग द चर्च. और उसका सबसे बड़ा रीजन है, यू नो, द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ बाइबल इनटू द लैंग्वेज ऑफ द कॉमन पीपल. पहले जर्मन में ट्रांसलेट हुआ, उसके बाद जर्मन से उसको दूसरे लैंग्वेजेस में ट्रांसलेट किया गया. और जब लोगों ने खुद बाइबल को पढ़ा, दे स्टार्टेड सीइंग दैट, ओ माय गॉड, द चर्च इज बिट्रेइंग अस, द चर्च इज फूलिंग अस. सो रेनेसांस पीरियड फोकस्ड ऑन इंडिविजुअल रिलीजन and focused human's life on earth and not in heaven. Renaissance period mein writers, philosophers, in logon ne kya bola? They started saying that even if you do not believe in God, it's fine, it's okay. And if you believe in God, it's your opinion. You can follow God in whatever way you want. Church should not dictate you what you should do and what you should not do. So people during the Renaissance period, they focused more on humans' life on earth when they are alive. What humans want, what humans need, what humans can do. Understood this slide, everyone who are present?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Next. This also we discussed. See, this is Ptolemy. I'm sure this is not his original photograph, but Ptolemy, he was born in 100 CE and died in 170 CE, 70 years he lived, gave the geocentric system of universe. Here you can see it's a sketch. In the center is the earth and all around is the sun and all the planets. So this was the geocentric system, which we discussed yesterday. That means earth is at the center of universe. And all other planetary bodies are revolving around it. This theory was believed and also was propagated by church. Propagated means church ne bhi isi theory pe believe karke logon mein phailaya. Remember students, any person who went against this theory of the church, they were very brutally punished. Like Galileo Galilei. This is Nicolaus Copernicus. Renaissance led to many scientific discoveries in the field of astronomy. Nicolaus Copernicus gave scientific evidence that the sun is the center of universe and moons, earth, other planets revolve around sun, which is heliocentric system of universe. Yaad rakhna bachcho, Copernicus ke liye universe jitna wo dekh sakte the, it was only the universe. Thus, Ptolemaic system of astronomy was replaced by Copernican system. Here you can see the Copernican model. I think is the kind of photograph which you can see here. You all must have seen in your geography books also, isn't it? Sun in the center and yes, you know, sir. The part of the earth which is towards the sun, it is daytime, and the part which is not towards the sun is nighttime. Chalo, next. Understood this slide? Should we go ahead, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next. Yesterday we also talked about exploration in the Renaissance. Here is the photograph, and here you can see ships. Adventurers started setting foot beyond the boundaries of land into sea, leading to new geographical discoveries. New geographic knowledge overturned the Europe-centric view that the Mediterranean Sea was the center of the world. You know, earlier Europeans used to think that only Mediterranean is the center of the world because, you know, Mediterranean ke beyond wo kabhi gaye hi nahi the. But now, with new geographical explorations, with new ships and people like Columbus and Vasco da Gama and others, you know, they started discovering new areas of the world, new oceans, new seas. The Renaissance also witnessed discovery and exploration of new continents. Now, during Renaissance, feudal system declined. Yesterday, if you remember, we discussed feudal system also.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you all can see this diagram of the feudal system.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How many students are there in the class, Bhumi, right now?
Sir, 17.
17. Okay, good. So here, dekho, ab achse samajh mein aayega. What is feudal system? Feudal pyramid of power. At the top, king. King gave the land to nobles, or then land was given, or fief was given to the knight vassals. The knight vassals gave the land and protection. Okay, just a second, everyone. I think some students are waiting in the lobby. Okay, Swadha. Just a second. Okay, Digant also is there in the meeting. Good. Can you all again see the?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So then, land and protection. Matlab, king gave the land to the nobles. Nobles gave the land to the warrior class, the knight vassals. And the knight vassals gave the land and also the protection. That is, the knight vassals of the warrior class, so they will protect other people, that is to the peasants. Peasants mein do tarah ke peasants hote hain, the rich peasants, the rich farmers, and the poor peasants. Ab inko bhi kuch wapas dena hai. So the peasants, what they will give? Obviously, the farmers, they will give food and services. Food, as they are doing agriculture, they will give food, they will give grains, and also different kind of services like labor, labor to make roads, labor to make buildings, whatever, etc., etc. Servants. Now, knight vassals, what they will give to the nobles? Protection and military service. That is the warrior class, they can fight. So they will protect the nobles also and the military service they will give. And nobles, what they will give to the king? Money and knights. Now, nobles, they were the very rich class. So whenever the king needed money, he will get that money from the nobles as taxes. And also, whenever the king is in need of an army, the nobles will also supply the knight vassals for fighting on behalf of the king. This was the feudal system. Ab isse kya hua? Nobles started demanding more and more services from the vassals and even taxes. Vassals demanded more and more money and taxes from the farmers, and that is how the farmers' life became very, very, very bad. This was the feudal system. Samajh mein aa raha hai students? Bahut detail mein jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. This diagram, everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So kya hua? Ab dheere dheere, what happened? During the Renaissance period, ye feudal system dheere dheere tootne laga. The business classes emerged. So new heights achieved in the growth of commerce and trade. Commerce and trade flourished, which led to prosperity in Europe. Commerce and trade, that is trade, business, big business families came up. Yesterday, I even told you one business family's name, which patronized Leonardo da Vinci. Anyone remembers?
The Medici.
Yes, the Medici family of Italy. Okay. And mainly they were of Florence, the city Florence. Many big business families came up in European countries who patronized artists and scientists. Next. Yesterday we discussed about the mariner's compass also in the class.
Yes, sir.
So see, this is the mariner's compass. It was an era when mariner's compass and gunpowder were innovated. This is gunpowder. Bachcho, gunpowder hai. Khane ki cheez nahi hai. Okay, बारूद है. Gunpowder means बारूद. So बारूद के इस्तेमाल से, you know, with the help of gunpowder, guns came into being, and the entire system of how to fight a war changed. Before gunpowder was there, बच्चों कैसे करके लड़ाई लड़ी जाती थी? Before the gunpowder,
sir, swords.
Swords,
swords,
swords and spears,
swords, spears. And you know, other, you know, all the other kinds of different such things. But with the gunpowder, cannons,
melee weapons.
Yes, mainly the weapons which were used directly with the use of hands. But with the discovery of gunpowder, you know, everything changed in the world. And so rajao ke liye ye bahut बड़ा चीज था गन पाउडर. एंड फॉर द एडवेंचरर्स, जिनको नई जगहों को खोजना था विद द हेल्प ऑफ द सी रूट, उनके लिए मैरिनर्स कंपास वाज अ ब्लेसिंग. बट फॉर द स्कॉलर्स एंड थिंकर्स, इट वाज मेनली अ टाइम ऑफ द रिवाइवल ऑफ क्लासिकल लर्निंग. क्लासिकल लर्निंग मीन्स द लर्निंग ऑफ, यू नो, कल्चर, लिटरेचर and wisdom after a long period of cultural decline and stagnation. Maine kal bataya tha, Renaissance period ke pehle Europe's condition was very bad. All the time there is war, war and war, otherwise disease, people were corrupt, church was absolutely corrupt, you know, people were busy in their corrupt lives, you know, everyone had forgotten their glorious past, their history. So it was a dark period of Europe. And with that, Black Death came, where millions and millions of people died. So Renaissance was really a time of rebirth. Ab bachcho samajh mein aa raha hai? Are you all getting an idea why Renaissance is called rebirth?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Let's go. Now, origins and rise of humanism. Bachcho, you all have heard, I don't know if anyone's elder brother or sister has taken arts or humanities in their 11th or 12th, but you must have heard this stream, humanities stream. Zarur suna
hoga?
Yes, sir.
Yes, humanities. अभी जो सोशल साइंस पढ़ रहे हैं बच्चों यही बाद में ह्यूमैनिटीज हो जाता है. ऑब्वियसली यू ऑल कैन गेट द मीनिंग दैट ह्यूमैनिटीज और ह्यूमनिज्म वर्ड कम्स फ्रॉम ह्यूमन ह्यूमन वर्ड से ये वर्ड आ रहा है. यस
सर.
अच्छा अभी हम लोग लाइक लेट अस से मैथ्स और साइंस कैन यू अप्लाई साइंटिफिक थिंग्स टू डील विद द सोसाइटी. अभी शादी ब्याह हो रहा है उसमें आप साइंस के फॉर्मूला और मैथ्स का फॉर्मूला लगा के आप शादी ब्याह का सब चीज कर सकते हो? बोलो. नो ना.
नो सर.
इफ यू वांट टू बी अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट और इफ यू वांट टू बी अ पॉलिटिशियन यू विल अप्लाई साइंस एंड मैथमेटिक्स एंड दीज थिंग्स. इज गोइंग टू वर्क इन द सोसाइटी?
नो सर.
नो सर.
सो साइंस एंड मैथमेटिक्स दे हैव देयर वर्क इन देयर ओन वे. But the world runs on which subjects? Social science, isn't it?
Yes,
yes.
So humanism. What is humanism in a nutshell? Or humanities ke subject aap dekhiye, aap agar kabhi lete hain 12th, 11th, 12th mein. Economics, which is the money factor of the entire world. How money flows, how money goes, economics. Then history, how we... our own past, we should know our own past, geography, psychology, our human mind, and so many other subjects are there, political science. So humanism in a nutshell, yahan pe kya hai? Putting human beings and other living things at the center of your moral outlook. You know, humans are so important. Jo bhi aap soch rahe hain, you think in the perspective of humans. Seeing the world as a natural space, and looking to science and reason to make sense of it. Or science or reason ka bhi aap istemal kare. Jo bhi cheez aap dunya mein dekh rahe hain, usko scientifically aap dekhe usko. Andhvishwas nahi. Do not see everything blindly. Billi rasta kaat ke chali gayi, okay, chalo 1 kilometer dobara, wapas jao. No, use science, use rationality, use your human brain to analyze things of the world. Promoting and supporting human flourishing across all frontiers. That is, humans should develop in all aspects of life and championing human rights for everyone. That is, humans should get all kind of rights. And that's about it. So, is humanism concept ka uday kab hua? When it started, when in Europe people started thinking more about humans and not about God and church, it was the Renaissance. The term Middle Ages was coined by scholars in the 15th century. 15th century means which year, students?
Sir, 1400s,
correct. So Middle Ages jo hai, ye scholars ne banaya tha is word ko in the 15th century to designate the interval between the downfall of the classical world of Greece and Rome and its rediscovery at the beginning of 15th century. So मतलब क्या हुआ, एक समय एंशिएंट ग्रीस और रोम जब था, जब वो उसका धीरे धीरे खत्म होने लगा, उस समय से लेके रेनेसांस के शुरू होने के ठीक पहले तक का समय, दैट वाज टर्म्ड एज द मिडिल एज. इवेंट्स एट द एंड ऑफ मिडिल एजेस पर्टिकुलरली विच ग्रेट स्टूडेंट दृष्टि अगेन इज जॉइनिंग, आई थिंक शी गॉट डिस्कनेक्टेड, जस्ट ओके. Yeah, events at the end of Middle Ages, particularly beginning in the 13th century, set in motion a series of social, political, and intellectual transformations that culminated in the Renaissance. Intellectual students means, anyone knows what is intellectual? Bachcho? Intellectual. Yes. Everything related to our mind, our thinking. Okay. The way humans think, intellectual. Got it? So events at the end of the Middle Ages. Middle Ages jab khatam ho raha tha, us samay kuch aisi cheeze hui, particularly 13th century se ye shuru hue, that is from the 1200s. That is, tarah tarah ki social cheezon mein change aaye, political cheezon mein changes aane shuru hue, log zyada se zyada sochna shuru kiye, log question karna shuru kiye society ke bare mein. People started asking, why is it like that? Why is it like that? You know, why it cannot be done like that? People started thinking with their brains, people started questioning the wrong things of the society. और इन्हीं सब चीजों से शुरू होते होते at the end Renaissance started. Humanism was an intellectual movement. Okay, quickly, any student can find the dictionary meaning of the word intellectual? जल्दी से तुरंत. Anyone?
Connecting with a person's ability to think a logical way to understand things.
Again, Digant, slowly say the meaning.
Connecting with a person's ability to think in a logical way and to understand things.
Correct. That is intellectual means, that is when we use our brains to analyze and understand things logically, in a logical way. Logically means जिसमें कोई रीजन हो. काली बिल्ली रास्ता काट के चलेगी तो हमको रास्ता नहीं क्रॉस करना है, ये क्या लॉजिकल थिंकिंग है बच्चों?
नो सर.
अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज लॉजिकल? लॉजिकल थिंग मींस व्हिच हैज अ मीनिंग, व्हिच हैज अ रियल सेंस एंड नॉट ब्लाइंड फेथ. सो इंटेलेक्चुअल मूवमेंट मींस व्हेन पीपल स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग रैशनली अबाउट द वर्ल्ड व्हिच शोड द स्पिरिट ऑफ रेनेसांस. It began in Italy. इसीलिए Renaissance period में इतने scientists आए, you know, from Newton to Galileo Galilei to Copernicus, so many. आप बस Google करिए scientists of the Renaissance period, आपको बहुत से lists मिल जाएंगे. It began in Italy. कहाँ पे ये शुरू हुआ? Humanism का ये movement Italy में शुरू हुआ. Its predecessors were men like Dante and Petrarch. ये दो नाम याद रखना, दांते और पेट्रार्क जो हैं, इन्होंने ह्यूमनिज्म मूवमेंट को शुरू किया था इन इटली. अच्छा बच्चों, इस चीज से थोड़ा हटके, इटली का एक बड़ा फेवरेट ही फूड डिश है. एनीवन कैन नेम टू फूड डिशेस ऑफ
इटली? पिज्जा.
यस,
पिज्जा
एंड
पिज्जा एंड पास्ता.
यस करेक्ट. एंड चीज. पिज्जा, पास्ता एंड चीज.
सर स्पेगेटी.
स्पेगेटी, यस करेक्ट. Spaghetti and also cheese. Italy is famous for its cheese. Yes. So,
but it is Swedish.
Cheese is Swedish?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will have to find. But Italy's cheese is also famous. If it's not from Italy, but it's famous. Okay, chalo. I will find out. Thank you, Digant. I will find about it. Chalo. Now, artistic development and the emergence of Florence. Students, Florence is an Italian city. Very famous for its culture, art. It has beautiful, beautiful buildings. Leonardo da Vinci's, you know, stayed in Florence. You can see this painting. This is very famous painting, students. The Last Supper. यहाँ पे देख रहे हो? यहाँ पे एक in the center it एक ये this is the huge wall. एक ये wall है. It's a wall painting. It is Jesus Christ in the center and these are his followers and it is called the Last Supper. Isko kaha jata hai the Last Supper. After this, it is said that Jesus Christ was crucified in the Bible after the Last Supper. Supper means the last, you know, dinner. So this is a very, very, very famous painting again of the Renaissance period done in a wall. It's a huge wall actually. So artistic developments, it was in art that the spirit of Renaissance or the meaning of Renaissance achieved its sharpest formulation. Now art ke through logo ne Renaissance ke time pe apne andar ke, you know, bhavo ko, apne andar ke emotions ko bahar dikhane ki koshish ki. Apne creativity ko logo ne samne laya. Art came to be seen as a branch of knowledge. You know, अभी भी हो सकता है कुछ बच्चे सुनते हो, अगर वो पेंटिंग कर रहे हैं, एक क्यों टाइम वेस्ट कर रहे हो, पढ़ाई करो, यू नो, लाइक दैट थिंग. पढ़ाई भी इंपॉर्टेंट है, बट यू नो, पेंटिंग इज आल्सो आर्ट, इज आल्सो अ फॉर्म ऑफ अ नॉलेज. एंड इन द हैंड्स ऑफ मेन सच एज लियोनार्डो दा विंची, आर्ट वॉज इवन अ साइंस, अ मीन्स फॉर एक्सप्लोरिंग नेचर एंड रिकॉर्ड डिस्कवरीज. लियोनार्डो दा विंची के लिए आर्ट सिर्फ पेंटिंग बनाना नहीं था, आर्ट ऑल्सो मेंट साइंस, making science sketches, making new discoveries and exploring new things. Now in the work of artists like painters, sculptors and architects, etc., the dignity of man found expression. That is, human's dignity man's dignity, human's dignity, human's creativity became, you know, came out with the help of art. So yahan pe dekh sakte Leonardo da Vinci ka. You all can see this sketch of Leonardo da Vinci of the internal organs of the body.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it very similar to the sketch which you study?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
So see.
Sir, just the lungs are not there.
So see how Leonardo da Vinci, you know, Leonardo da Vinci, ho sakta aapko sunke bada ajeeb lagega, but you know, he was really, really crazy to gain more and more knowledge. So, aapko kya lagta hai? अब उस समय किसी को नहीं पता था इंसान की बॉडी के अंदर किस तरह चीजें हैं. कैन यू गेस हाउ ही गॉट टू नो हाउ थिंग्स वेयर इनसाइड ह्यूमन बॉडी?
बाय कटिंग डेड बॉडीज.
सर, सीइंग एंड टचिंग.
वेरी करेक्ट, बाय गेटिंग डेड बॉडीज. सो ही यूज्ड टू कीप अ लुक एट द ग्रेवयार्ड्स दैट विच पर्सन्स बॉडी इज गेटिंग बरीड राइट नाउ. क्योंकि फ्रेश बॉडी चाहिए एक्सप्लोरेशन करने के लिए. अगर सड़ा हुआ बॉडी आपको मिलेगा, रॉटन बॉडी, यू वोंट बी एबल टू डू समथिंग. एंड देन एट द नाइट ही हैड वन टू यू नो असिस्टेंट्स विद देम. यू नो ही यूज्ड टू गो टू द ग्रेवयार्ड, गेट सम ऑफ द बॉडीज, मे बी यू नो लावारिस बॉडीज. ही स्पेशली यूज्ड टू टेक सच बॉडीज. यू नो मेनी पीपल वर हैंग्ड दोज डेज. कुछ भी गलती होता था लोगों को फांसी दे दी जाती थी. ही यूज्ड टू गेट सच बॉडीज who had no one, then used to cut them and used to explore the human body so that, you know, new medicines can be made, new things can be done. Also, you can see the next thing. Doesn't it look like an aircraft?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, Leonardo da Vinci used to see the flying birds. Wo flying birds ko dekhte the and used to make sketches. Then he made many such sketches, though unka ye sketch kabhi reality nahi bana. But he was so curious. He was a multi-talented genius. Maybe, you know, आज अगर हम उनके स्केच पे कुछ और थोड़ा ज्यादा काम करें, हम कर सकते हैं. So, impact of Renaissance was mostly visible in Italy, where many universities also came. And thus, the ideas of humanism and Renaissance spread all over Europe. बहुत से नए-नए. So, आज का homework, छोटा सा होमवर्क, नॉट टुडे, अभी टेस्ट पे फोकस करें. लेटर फाइंड आउट सम नेम्स, एटलीस्ट 3 यूनिवर्सिटी नेम्स विच वेर फाउंडेड इन इटली ड्यूरिंग द रेनेसांस टाइम. यू ऑल कैन डू दैट. 3 यूनिवर्सिटीज विच वेर फाउंड इन इटली और विच वेर मेड इन इटली ड्यूरिंग द रेनेसांस टाइम. यू कैन फाइंड दैट.
यस सर.
यस सर.
ओके, सो थोड़ा समझ में आ गया आपके. इन वट एवर इज गिवन इन योर कोमेट, आई मेड इट इन दिस वे सो दैट यू ऑल कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट प्रॉपरली. शो दो स्लाइड्स आर हेल्पफुल नाउ. व्हाट डू यू ऑल थिंक? इट्स ओके?
यस सर.
ओके, एंड एट द एंड अभी हम जो नेक्स्ट चैप्टर शुरू करने वाले हैं, नॉट आफ्टर द यूनिट टेस्ट, वी विल स्टार्ट ज्योग्राफी सिविक्स चैप्टर ओनली. We studied about marginalization. There is another chapter on marginalization. After that, we will start history. So in that, we will talk about Indian Renaissance. India mein bhi Renaissance hua. And I think you all have heard about Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Naam to zarur suna hoga Raja Ram Mohan Roy ka. So it is said, Raja Ram Mohan Roy is said to be the father of India's Renaissance, which started in the 19th century. Also, British called him the first modern man of India. He was the main person behind the abolition of sati pratha in India. That is, unhone hi tarah tarah ke evidences nikale, unhone pressurize kiya British government ko to abolish the sati pratha, and also he established a very famous institution called the Brahmo Sabha. Here you can see a stamp which was made by the Indian government on Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Here is one of his oil painting sketches. He used to look like this. Roy in London, 1833, portrayed by Rembrandt Peale. He was born in 22nd May 1772 at Radhanagar, Bengal, died in England only Other names, herald of new age, occupation, he was a social and religious reformer, known for Bengal Renaissance and Brahmo Sabha. That's his signature. This I got from the Wikipedia. So, is in read this slide again properly, everyone. And I think you all will be prepared for this topic because this topic does not have any question answers. This topic has no question answers. So that is why study these slides again one and two times more. And I think you will be able to do any question which comes from this in the test. I don't think shayad ek hi question aayega, only one question may come. Yes, Anushka.
Sir, in subjective test, this chapter question.